Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Osteo Med, a series of video lectures in osteology. The topic for today's discussion is skull, Norma, lateralis, part 3. Occipital region. Now we will start with a review slide which we have used in previous videos. From that slide you can see that we roughly divide the norma lateralis into an anterior, middle and posterior zones. We have finished the anterior and the middle zone. Now we cover the posterior or the occipital zone. Now the arrows indicate three important bones: the parietal bone, its postero inferior angle, the squamous part of the occipital bone, its lateral angle, and a third piece of bone, the mastoid part of temporal bone. These three are the key bones that cover this area. They meet at a particular point, and that's what I have shown in that blue white dotted circle. Now that circle is an important landmark in the norma lateralis, that is the asterion. That is the asterion. It's a junction point. It is also the location of the posterior fontanelle that you see in the newborn. For about 2 years it's open. Slowly it gets patched up because of the ossification coverage which reaches this area. Now the flashing arrows above the asterion reflects the junction between two bones, the posterior border of the parietal bone and the superior border of the squamous occipital. This border is, this junction is also known as the lambdoid suture, the lambdoid suture. A few more points that are to be noted. They may not be very prominent in a strict norma lateralis, but nevertheless it is there at the edge of the norma lateralis. Therefore, I have given a slightly different photograph where the norma occipitalis is better shown in addition to a large part of the norma lateralis. There are two flashing arrows. The upper flashing arrow is the external occipital protuberance. That's the occipital bone, a very prominent landmark of the occipital bone. A vertical ridge that goes down from the external occipital protuberance right up to the foramen magnum is the external occipital crest. That's the external occipital crest. Next, on either sides of the external occipital protuberance is a thick ridge of bone we call the superior nuchal line. Lower down about an inch below, or roughly midway between the external occipital protuberance and the posterior margin of the foramen magnum, there is another horizontal ridge. That ridge is the inferior nuchal line. Next, the two flashing arrows we have already covered, the superior and the inferior nuchal line. It's still here in this photograph, but then shift your focus to the circular area, dotted circle, that is blue white dotted circle, I have identified a junction and I called it as lambda. That junction is a point where the sagittal suture and the lambdoid suture meet at a point. I repeat, that point is called the lambda, where the interparietal suture meets the parieto-occipital suture. That junction point is called the lambda. That's the lambda. This is also the location of the posterior fontanelle, which you see in, immediately after birth for a few months. We have seen a similar fontanelle in the asterion. There it is posterolateral fontanelle, but this is the posterior fontanelle. Next, back to a typical normal lateralis view. We have already identified the inferior temporal line and its continuity lower down with the supratemporal crest. Right below the crest and immediately behind the external acoustic meatus is a triangle called the suprameatal triangle. That's an important part of the mastoid process, of the mastoid part of the temporal bone. You can also see the mastoid process lower down, a projecting piece of a bone. Now, the suprameatal triangle is an important surgical landmark because you can go through that and reach the mastoid antrum. That means it is the auditus, or it is the spot from the middle ear cavity. You can go through that and reach the rest of the mastoid ear cells. So it's a portal, or it is an entrance area. A few more points. The flashing arrow, there are two arrows there. They're close to the mastoid process. The upper flashing arrow is the mastoid notch. The lower flashing arrow is another notch, which is more medial to it. The upper arrow, namely the mastoid notch, gives attachment to the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. Whereas the other notch, more medial to it, the groove more medial to it, is the groove where the occipital artery runs backwards to enter the occipital area. Next, we have seen the tympanic plate in the discussion on the anterior wall of the external acoustic meatus. Trace it further down. This plate ends in a projection called the styloid. It ensheets the base of the styloid process. So the lower arrow is the styloid process, and the upper arrow is the tympanic plate. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any constructive feedback, please feel free to send this to my email ID. Or you can also write your feedback on the blog that is present right below the YouTube video. That was a presentation from the Anatomy Department, St. John's Medical College, Bangalore. In addition to osteology series of videos, we also have VBS Histomet, a series of about 90 plus histology videos, short videos to help you identify structures, useful for students in medical, dental, physiotherapy, nursing, and other allied courses. You can not only see the videos, access is free. You can also consider subscribing to this channel. And also, after subscribing, make sure you press the bell icon. This will ensure that as and when new videos are added, you will be given a notification. Thank you for your patient hearing.